85% of your financial success is going to come from your ability to communicate, negotiate, and lead. Okay. Got a negotiation coming up this Tuesday. Welcome to another episode of Self-Employed, excuse me, Success Secrets Saturday edition. On today's episode, we're going to talk about some negotiating secrets, okay? So a little backstory, there's this client that our company is working with. At the very beginning, we kind of made some mistakes and they reduced the price that they were paying us because it wasn't working out, it wasn't smooth, there was a lot of problems, and so we were just like, okay, let's reduce the price. And after some time went by, our performance completely turned around, and now we're in negotiation mode to go back to that price plus some more. Okay, this is also a testament to that you can mess up with a client and then things not turn out how they should, and then you can reverse it and get paid again. I've seen it happen. So if it doesn't work out perfectly the first time, there is usually problems. Don't give up. Just believe in yourself and try again. So basically, this secret is that at some point in your life, you're gonna have to negotiate. As we talked before on previous videos, that 85% of your financial success is gonna come from your ability to communicate, negotiate, and lead. 85%. So most of the money in your bank account right now is because of your ability to communicate, negotiate, and lead. And surprisingly, 15% only comes from technical ability. So whether you're an engineer, you paint houses, or you're a mechanic, your technical ability can only take you so far. So you're gonna have to negotiate. So listen up for this video. It tips in, and these tips come from a guy named Ted Lenhardt here in Seattle. He helps people who are quote unquote creatives, like graphic designers or artists or photographers, get the money that they need to have their business to go forward. So the first thing he said, remember, these are real secrets. He said, when you're negotiates, always negotiate in person. Don't negotiate via text, via email, by the phone. Negotiate in person, okay? Talking with someone face to face is some of the best intel you're going to get when it comes to negotiating, because you see everything, you can't hide, it's very organic. There are so many reasons why it's just best to work in person and negotiate in person. The next is, this is really interesting, I've never heard this before. He said, sell integratively, not distributively. Now, what does that mean? Integratively means, obviously, the root word is integrate, which means come together to work as one, meaning that. And then, how does this work out in practice is that when you're with someone at a table, usually when you're negotiating, you're sitting across from someone. It's very kind of adversarial in how it's set up physically. Like you're across from them. Like when you play a sport like football or basketball, you're across from each other, okay? When you sell integratively, you sit next to each other as if you're on the same team, like you're sitting on the bench together, okay? Sell integratively, not distributively. I've never heard this before, and this is a true secret that you probably won't hear anywhere else. And so I just wanna share it with you to help your business get to where you want it to be. And also to stay tuned for the very end for a surprise, is that you're gonna have to negotiate to get to where you want to go, and everything in life is negotiable, as the saying goes. And so keep these in mind as you live your life. That negotiation workshop meant so much to me, went so far as to laminate this, okay? And there's some good tips on this basic, because you're gonna have to negotiate. Remember, 85% of your financial success is gonna come from your ability to communicate, negotiate, and lead, okay? This is one of the three crucial aspects, okay? And basically just a list of things to do when you're negotiating. Like, one thing that's really good and sticks out is that your powers and your expertise, okay? Understand that and use that to your advantage. Have alternatives, okay? Meaning that you can go to someone else, like they're not the only person who can pay you. Manners matter, okay? Change the context, separate facts from feelings. This is just coming to the tips from him. This is from September 6, 2017. Okay, remember, negotiations are part of life, everything's fluid. So everything is up to persuasive speech. Okay, now this leads to today's surprise. Today's surprise is when you see a problem, say, I got it. Okay, whether you're negotiating your salary or negotiating negotiating with someone's going to pay your business. Understand that this is the skill you're going to need to cultivate. Yeah, it's hard. It's hard having a business. You're going to have to negotiate. And when people talk about money, money talks can be very nasty. They can be very toxic. They can be very vitriolic. And so you want to be find a way to do it and just be nice to them. Understand it's just money. Okay, you're going to be okay. They wouldn't be talking to you if they didn't need you. So you're probably going to get what you want, but make sure the other person gets what they want too. Remember, lastly, as always, unsuccessful people make decisions based on current situations, but you hopefully make decisions based on where you want to be. Okay.